Hello, we're standing at Lake Boulevard, the end of Lake Boulevard, which is a street in St. Clair Shores, sort of between, it's between 10 mile, 13 and 12 and 13 mile, excuse me, essentially, about halfway. But anyway, at the end of a couple of these residential streets is a little park that people have. It's only for the residents of that street. But underneath their park is a very important part of the Macomb County infrastructure, because there's what we call the Lake Boulevard drain, which is about a 12 foot diameter pipe drain. It's an old storm drain that was put in back in the 60s. Another one of these storm drains that has probably never been inspected. And in this case, this pipe, this drain goes from essentially I-94. It runs through St. Clair Shores, as I'm telling you, up these streets. And then it dead ends, or it discharges out into Lake St. Clair here. And this pipe runs, what, Joe, about a half a mile, would you say, out?
Yes.
Quarter of a mile, half a mile out. This is Joe Schadeford, who owns a company called Doetsch. And they do all kinds of work all over the country, actually, but they have done a lot of work for the Public Works Department. And this, I think, is the fourth storm drain we've had you inspect since I've been here in St. Clair Shores. We've done a number of other storm drains. Same kind of thing, about 12, 13 foot diameter pipes. One case that runs from East Point, discharges down in St. Clair Shores. Another one down by Memorial Park in St. Clair Shores. So it runs from sort of the Macomb Mall, runs out. Anyway, we have all these outfalls of storm drains that run into Lake St. Clair. Again, not been inspected for a long time, if ever. And so what we've done is we've been trying to get some grants, and we've been pretty successful at getting grants to inspect these storm drains. And we have another grant, and this project's going to be about $500,000. And you'd say, wow, that's a lot of money. What do you have to do? But Joe's going to explain to you what they have to do here. But essentially, particularly because the lake levels are so high right now, you can't get into these drains to inspect them, right? They are totally full of lake water. So there has to be a bulkhead that has to be built and installed to stop the lake water from coming into the drain, and then they have to dewater the drain, the pipe, so that they can go in and inspect it. So that's sort of it in a nutshell, but Joe, you can tell me what I missed here, but what are you gonna do?
So to get started, first off, what we're standing on is the discharge area of the drain. So we need to remove the slabs that are covering this in order to put that bulkhead in, as you had said. And so now we have a positive dam between the drain itself and the lake. And compounded with the high lake levels that we have, right now they're very high, but also I was actually talking beforehand that we may have to call a job because of wind. If we have wind in a higher level, it's going to go over the bulkheads.
Yeah.
So we definitely have our set of challenges on this. But what we're going to do is when we make that positive dam, we're able then to pump all the water out that historically has always been flooded in that pipe. When it's flooded, there's no way to see to check for integrity or to check for illicit taps,
mm-hmm.
For that deeds of the past, really. And so by dewatering that, we're able to inspect it. We're also able to check any sediment, which we'll sample as well to give you the data that if there is any future or further either cleaning or repairs that need to be made, because you have what's in there.
Yeah.
And
well, one thing that Joe's talking about here when he said illicit connections. We check everything to see, you know, for instance, somebody might have put their sanitary sewer pipe into our storm drain. Or they, you know, there could be other things that are there. And so we're always checking for E. coli. You always hear about E. coli. We want to make, we call it the IDEP testing that we're doing. And the only reason I'm interrupting Joe here is one of the drains that we cleaned, the first one actually we had him inspect, was the Stevens drain, which again is a 12 or 13 foot diameter pipe that runs from East Point, runs down to St. Clair Shores and discharged at one of the marinas here in St. Clair Shores. And for 33 years at least, an apartment complex had an illicit connection, had their sanitary sewer running into the storm drain. listen, first of all, the people that live there now were as horrified as we were. So you mentioned the sins of the past. Who knows what you're going to find here? In that case, we find them, we fix them. We had that thing fixed in a day. Now, I hope we're not going to find anything like that here, but we don't know. That's what we're checking for. We're looking for that. And as you say, the integrity of the pipe, really. We're in the drain business. So we have to make sure these drains are working properly, because having good drainage, obviously, impacts flooding in neighborhoods or stabilizes the roadbeds. So it's really important that we have good drainage. But not to interrupt, but go ahead.
No, absolutely. And that goes back to those illicit taps that we find. It isn't necessarily that it was purposeful. It may have been that somebody didn't know it at a certain time. But it also goes to what you're putting down these storm drains in your street. There is no waste treatment plant. It goes directly from that drain off the roads right here into the lake. So anything that it's untreated. Right. And so that's why it's very important to make sure that doesn't happen, that your sanitary flows go to waste treatment where they need to be and treated properly before they're discharged, instead of using the lake as the as a discharge point.
It's so true, and it also needs to be a continual education, particularly for our children, that they understand that everything that goes down the storm drains, you see your little storm grate at the end of your driveway. All the oils from your car or, you know, the whatever's going down that storm drain, as Joe just said, it's not going to a waste treatment plant. It's going to eventually find its way right out into the lake. So we always need to make sure that we're not, we just had a case up in Chesterfield Township where a kid was cleaning out a garage and the neighbors watched him pour some paint down the storm drain. We had Joe come out and we cleaned it up. But, you know, sometimes it's just, let's think about this, right? You can't keep putting this stuff down storm drains and running it out into the lake. But again, these major storm drains, which is what we're doing here at Lake Boulevard, need to be inspected on a regular basis. We have to look at the integrity, that there's not degradation in the pipe, and also any kind of illicit connections, or, as you say, sedimentation. Mm-hmm. So when you're down there, what will your guys actually be doing?
Well, So after it's dewatered and it's ventilated for safe entry, the crew has is they have a closed circuit TV camera that's on a tether. So as they're walking through, they're on a closed circuit communication with the camera truck and with the engineers, and so it's almost as if the engineers are in the pipe with them, because they're communicating with them, and by camera they're able to look at the walls.
Right.
The crown, the invert of the pipe, and so what they see, they can give verbal feedback, and as well as what's witnessed in the camera van, they can communicate back with the crews. All this video is recorded, and it's observed, and then passed on
we can figure out what we want to do
to your apartment,
what we need to do, what we can afford to do,
department.
And that's really what we'll do then. We'll analyze all that department and we'll figure out all the information. We'll sort of figure out, you know, in a lot of cases, you don't have to do anything, right? Hopefully, that there's nothing, but if there is work to be done, then at least we know how to prioritize the work and try to cost it out and figure out what we really need to do to maintain these drains in these pipes. And I'm sorry I have my sunglasses on while I'm doing this video, but I am literally staring right into the sun, and I'm too old anymore. I can't do that.
That's why I'm looking sideways.
I got my old eyes here, so I just can't stare directly into the sun anymore. But anyway, we're excited to get this project underway.
Absolutely.
Joe's going to be starting here. And you're watching this. It looks like a sunny day here, but we've got a break in the weather, fortunately. We're just starting here the first part of February. But how long do you think this project will take you?
So we'll plan to start dewatering here at the end of next week.
Yeah.
And then our surveys will take us about 2 weeks as well. So about a month.
Okay. All right. Well, anyway, we appreciate the grant that we got from the state of Michigan. So we appreciate that to help us undertake this work. And you know, if we find anything that's really needs to be done that might be beyond our means, we'll be going to the city of St. Clair Shores. And so they are well aware that we're doing this. This project, and Mayor Walby and the entire City Council of St. Clair Shores has been extremely supportive of all the different projects that we have done here in St. Clair Shores. In the case of the one incident I told you that we found on the Stevens Drain, that was the City of East Point. they came right out, they helped us, and you know, we had a different thing in Roseville. They've been out, they've been helping us, so we're working with our local partners here in every way that we can. And you know what? The lake, this water, it doesn't know if it's a resident of St. Clair Shores or Roseville or the state of Michigan or wherever, right? It's all hands on deck. This is our lake, in Macomb County. We're big residents here of this Lake St. Clair, and it's for all of us to be the best stewards that we possibly can. And so this is just one more thing. You know, if you think of all the different contaminants you might find in a lake, it doesn't just come from one thing. It's all these different things. And so you just got to keep sort of, you know, working away at it and do the best that we can to clean it all up. So anything else I missed, Joe?
I think you've got it covered.
All right, good. Thanks for joining us.